Across Yorkshire's moors and dales, the world's most famous vet set the benchmark for animal care. And James Herriot's legacy lives on. His former trainee, Peter Wright, has been a Yorkshire vet...
All right, fella, no one's shaking your head at me.
..for 40 years.
Many years ago, this is what my old boss taught me to use, and it's done the job for me very well over the years.
New life.
Fills me full of so much joy.
Now running a new Yorkshire practice, Peter's former partner, Julian Norton...
Hello.
..also upholds the Herriot ethos.
I'm feeling a lot better, thank you.
And in the foothills of the Pennines...
Come on, lads.
..at one of the country's busiest animal hospitals...
So cool.
..a new generation of town and country vets are following in their footsteps.
Shona's just touched me through the cow, which feels very strange.
Feet, two, one.
The vet teams have one common goal.
It's called the art of veterinary science.
I love it.
..to help animals of all shapes...
..quicker than I was expecting.
..sizes...
Hello, dear.
..types...
Yeah, I'm on, big boy.
Ow!
..and temperaments.
Good boy, I said, not bad boy.
It's definitely not glamorous.
It smells like mouldy cheese or something like that.
But it's varied.
Come on, Jim, I don't know whether I can.
It's rarely easy.
Oh, it's escape.
But they continue the Herriot tradition.
They're a bit wild, the cattle over here.
Treating all creatures great.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Chill, chill, chill.
It's one of these jobs where you need your porridge before you start.
And small.
I need some glasses, he's so small.
The four seasons shape the scenery and soundtrack of Yorkshire. From the unmistakable colours of autumn leaves and the familiar riffs of November rain to the timeless, captivating charms of a winter wonderland. When spring is in the air, the landscape strums to the beat of life. And in the summertime, the countryside is at its most bright and beautiful. But for a Yorkshire vet, there's not always chance to relax on summer nights. On a warm evening in the Dales, Julian's just arrived at Suzanne Benson's Llama Trekking Centre after hearing about a youngster who suffered a freak accident.
Well, it's a bit of a crisis. I had a rather fraught phone call from Suzanne. We think there might be a break to the jaw, so that won't be very good if that's the case.
Good boy.
Fingers crossed it's not as bad as it sounds.
For Suzanne and farmhand Charlotte, it's been a stressful few hours.
He's sad. He's normally much sort of happier and more...
Full of character.
Full of life, but... He's just looking a little bit like what's happening at the moment, and I'm probably very hungry.
Hello.
Hiya.
What happened?
Well, he was just knocked clean off his feet by a big llama this morning. Charlotte didn't quite see it happen, but she heard the thud on the floor.
So his head went thud on the floor?
Yeah, completely flat, and he didn't move to start with. I thought he was dead. Then he started to bleed from his mouth and froth, wasn't he, out of his mouth. And then there's, like, little bits of teeth coming out as well. His teeth had, like, crumbled further back.
It's all right, it's all right, it's all right.
He's not eating, and he's swollen here, and he's very tender. He doesn't want you to touch it, but there's heat coming from his face.
Right.
I know.
And have you been able to look in any detail, or not really? Hello.
He's in so much pain, we can't really get that mouth open.
You're worried, aren't you? There's some saliva, some drool at the front of his little mouth. It looks like there's some swelling on the right-hand side of his jaw, but I think it's obviously going to be really painful. Without stressing him, I think the plan of action is going to be to give him some sedation, some intravenous sedation, and then he'll go really sleepy, and that'll make it possible to examine him in a bit more detail. I'll come in. I think we'll be able to do him in there.
It's OK.
Good boy.
I think sometimes animals realise when they do need help and when help's here. Because he's not really complaining about this, is he?
No.
This is some sedative.
Good lad, good boy.
Here we are, that's in.
Shh, 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 shh. Good boy, you're OK.
Shh,
Right, okay. Right, you're right. You feel a bit sleepy.
Good boy. You're okay. You're okay. Good boy.
Good boy.
So we should kind of just go sleepy now. So I'm trying to work out what's happened. I'm feeling inside his mouth to try and feel if there's anything loose. It's a bit hard to tell, because they do move, obviously, the mouth from side to side.
You thought it was a bit clunky, didn't you, earlier? Really? It's just on that side.
It? It's got, like, a little cut here, but when I were feeling that earlier, it felt like there was a lot of moving.
Yes. Yeah, you're right, there's a fracture there, look. So where my thumb is there,
yeah,
I can feel it more than see it.
Bother.
All right, what can I do about that?
At the practice in Kirby Moorside, Kirsty and her pet goat have just arrived to see Peter.
Hello.
Hello.
And this, and you, and this must be Gertrude.
This is Gertrude. She's quite lame on her front right foot, and she's been taking the weight off it quite a lot. She's been putting herself over a barrel to kind of take the weight off.
Really?
And she's been going
down. Holding the barrel under her chest?
Yes.
Has she?
Yes.
So her left foot isn't particularly good either, then?
No.
Interesting. I'd just like to see her walking.
Okay. Come on, Gertrude.
Come on, dear. Come and see the nasty man.
Gertrude. Good girl.
You all right? Yeah.
She's quite heavy.
That's it. There we are, Gertrude. That's lovely.
Good girl. Here we go. I'll go more on
this bit. Yeah.
Peter's keen for a closer examination of Gertrude's feet.
There potentially could be something very serious going on here. So let's have a look and see. Right, Gertrude, let's have a look. That hoof wall has grown completely over there. You can see on here there's the sole, but the wall of the hoof here has completely grown over the sole of the foot.
That's quite unusual.
Yes, it is. Let's have a look at the back ones, Eloise, there. It's just, yeah, it's starting to happen a little bit on these as well. All right, let's have a look at the other one as well. You're a model patient, aren't you?
She's really good.
She's a good goat.
Yeah. The other foot's actually worse. You can see what's like the wall is actually curving over the underside of her foot. So this is painful. These feet are deformed. I'd like her to have some x-rays. It certainly isn't just a case of sending her home with medication.
It's not nice to hear the animals in pain, and obviously they tend to cover it up quite well because they just want to get on with their life, but yeah, it's not great that she's in pain, so it'd be nice to get it sorted out.
Let's just hope it's something we can do something about.
Yeah.
Coming up,
this is emergency makeshift operating in a field.
Trying to fix the young llama's broken jaw, Julian hits problems.
I don't think that's going to work.
Peter doesn't like what he sees on Gertrude's x-rays.
This isn't an easy problem.
And Nat has no time to lose when a bulldog is poisoned.
Fingers crossed we've caught it in time.
I'll be back soon.
At the Llama Trekking Centre, Julian, Suzanne and Charlotte are worried about youngster Rowan.
Well, it's broken.
Who suffered a serious jaw injury.
No wonder he can't eat.
No wonder he can't eat. Right, what I think we'll do, I'm going to try and get some wire around his teeth to act like a very snazzy brace. This is emergency makeshift operating in a field. I'm trying to thread it through the gum, through this needle. That's not really going to be firm enough through there. Right, I don't think that's going to work.
My biggest fear is him not being able to chew the cud and obviously his digestion doesn't work then, so hoping the procedure works and enables him to eat again.
I'm gonna try and make a hole in the jaw and thread the wire through. It's not very nice, but it's for the best if it's right. So, there we are, that's through. This is to get the wire through the jaw. That's fine, that's in, that's through. Right, excellent. So that's gone through one side of the fracture. And then what I'm gonna do now with this is push it through there.
Convenient hole.
Through that convenient gap in his teeth. As that tightens, that'll pull it all into alignment.
It sounds like there's hope in Julian's voice, but obviously if it doesn't do the trick, it might be the end for Rowan, so anyway, not even gonna think about that at the moment. Let's think positive.
Right, and then I'm gonna just cut that off and then bend it. I think that's quite stable, look. It's not moving. It doesn't need to be perfect, no. But it just needs to be together.
He's not a show llama. As long as it does the trick, he can eat and chew his cud.
And it's happy.
And he's happy and comfortable. That's all that matters.
I think we'll just think ourselves lucky that we've got it together, you know. Hopefully, that'll be enough to keep it together and allow it to heal.
So just leave him with some hay tonight, yeah? And some water and... or not rush it.
Would it be better to feed him on something more concentrated, do you think? Like some hard feed?
Soaked, maybe.
Soaked,
so
yeah.
It's just like mush.
Fingers crossed.
Yeah, fingers crossed. It's going to work, Rose.
It's got to work, Rose.
Has to do.
Good, right.
OK,
yeah.
Right.
Cheerio, have
Thank
a good evening.
Much.
See you, Rowan. It's a nasty fracture. It feels stable. There's a lot of healing to go on, but I think the future looks pretty bright for him if he can get over the next 24 hours.
My main concern is just improving from this now and coming around from the sedation and getting him eating again. That's my main concern because we've got to get him eating to survive. I feel more hopeful, but it's still a huge worry because obviously if it doesn't work, then it is the end for him.
In Kirby Moorside, Peter's hoping to get to the bottom of Gertrude the goat's painful foot problem.
We'll take her through and we'll see how we get on. Come on, good girl. Bit of fuss and she'll go with anybody, won't she?
He and vet Sophie need to take some x-rays.
I'm sure the gums are getting smaller. Right, Gertrude, come on. I think this is probably the first goat's foot I've ever x-rayed in 40 years. Right. We've got a very abnormal hoof wall here. Let's see what this one's like. Again, we've got a very similar scenario here where we've got this huge, massive wall that's grown underneath the foot, over the sole. I think these pedal bones are slightly abnormal as well. I think this is probably associated with a condition called laminitis.
Mm. This is a foot problem that Peter knows all too well.
Laminitis is an incredibly painful condition in all species. It's often associated with rich food, but we'll get this gross abnormality in the feet. And not only is it painful, but you're actually walking on the painful bits as well. So it's a horrible condition. This isn't an easy problem. Right, let's go back and see your mother. I just cannot see any future, really, in leaving her as she is.
No, she's not happy.
No. Could we have her in for a short while?
Yes.
We didn't play this game before, did we, when we x-rayed you? This is a new one. That's it. Well, this is an oscillating saw. What I'm trying to do here is take the hoof wall back.
Well, it's actually growing underneath. It shouldn't be growing down underneath. And that's our problem. Looking a bit better, isn't it? We've gone as far as we can now on this sole because we're just starting to see the sensitive tissues underneath. Let's have a look at the other one now. If you look there, we've got bruising there.
Yeah.
That's quite soft. I think this is probably more deformed than the other foot in many ways.
Yeah, more chronic.
Yeah. I've got to leave that, I think, for it to walk on. And there's a little bit more normality in that hoof shape now. And I think we've improved those immensely, the shape of them.
Looks a lot better.
It does.
Does she want some pain relief?
Yes, without doubt.
She's coming round.
Yeah, lovely. It's always a good thing, isn't it?
With Gertrude's owner, Kirsty, here to collect her, there's already cautious optimism.
I was wondering if she's standing a bit better.
I think she is. She's definitely standing better.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely. She looks a lot better. Her feet look a lot neater, I think.
Aww. So you've had your pedicure, Gertrude. It's time to go home. Oh, yes, there we are. That's lovely. Interesting, I've not seen her shift her weight on those front feet once yet.
Yeah, she's not lifted it up, has she?
Yeah.
Hopefully. It's a good start.
It is a good start, yes. But, I mean, see how she goes.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thank you. OK, we'll keep everything crossed. Thank you.
See you later.
Bye.
As skies darken over Huddersfield, two very worried dog owners have just rushed into the animal hospital.
Come on through. Come on, Jeff. Let's have you in.
Greg and Siobhan's young bulldog, Jeff, has eaten some chewing gum, and Matt knows that spells trouble.
When did he eat it?
It's probably
about 45 minutes ago. Yeah.
Right, OK. And how much did he eat?
I don't know, to be honest. I'm not sure.
It was sick a lot. They said there's an ingredient there or something.
Is it
xylitol?
Yeah, which I looked at the ingredients and it was like it was on there. So
it's very potent and we are going to have him in on some fluids and charcoal and such, purely because it's caused vomiting. What xylitol does, it causes a massive insulin release from the pancreas, and as such, that can crash the blood sugars, and that can occur within the space of 2 hours. Now, given it's 45 minutes ago, it could be that insulin's being released and those sugars are dropping down, so we need to keep an eye on that sugar level, and obviously it can affect the liver, so we'll get him on a drip and some fluids over the next 24 hours, and we'll monitor that blood glucose, and certainly the next few hours we'll be in close touch. All right, you happy? Happy going ahead with everything?
Yeah, he's not going to be.
It is quite serious. So, fingers crossed we've caught it in time. Okay. Right. I'll be back soon. Yeah, if we can get him dripped upon some fluids, but we're going to get some bloods as well and monitor the glucose hourly for the next 6 hours. This is going to be a job and a half. Oh, he's not going to like this.
The team need to treat and monitor Jeff right away.
Just relax. Relax.
Hello,
look, it's not a scary thing. Oh, sniff.
And unlike Jeff, Nurse Jodie understands the urgency.
We need to get a catheter. I'm gonna have to put him on floor and sit on him if he wants to get a catheter.
Yeah, let's sit on floor. Let's go on floor. Come on, Jeffrey. Come on, Jeffrey.
Good boy.
Good lad.
Brave boy. Good lad. Wait still, good lad.
Step at a time.
Good boy.
For what we need to do to him is going to be a challenge this next few hours, and unfortunately, it's not one that we can just ignore and just see how we get on. And they can go into fits, and it obviously can be fatal if it's not managed quickly enough.
Good boy.
Coming up. Will it be two steps forward or one step back for Gertrude?
Worst case scenario is that she's got worse.
Julian visits one of his favourite former clients.
Poo, 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 poo. A lot of poo.
Poo. What's the
poo? You can have him. Poo.
And they know all about that.
He's got what we call the trucks.
At Jean and Steve's.
They're called Bubble and Squeak.
Where it's squeaky bum time.
That's pretty watery diarrhoea.
At the animal hospital in Huddersfield.
Yes, you've poisoned yourself, haven't you?
Matt's worried that Jeff the bulldog is in real danger after eating some chewing gum.
One of these chewing gum tablets, if it's the strawberry flavour one, will be enough to cause massive toxic damage to him. That can result in liver failure, low blood glucose, which could cause him to fit and die. Hopefully, that's not going to happen.
The team need to get some fluids into Jeff. But he's not making it easy.
Wait.
Keep it raised, keep it raised, keep it raised, keep it raised.
Wait. Good boy. Good boy. All right, darling, I'm sorry. Good lad. Just wait still. Wait still. Good boy, good boy. Good boy. Breathe, dog, breathe. Good boy.
Run in, run in, stop.
That's it, nice. Good boy.
That's going in nicely.
That's it. We've done it now. Is he good boy?
an underestimation of trickiness.
Come on.
Well held by the team.
Come here.
There's now a long night ahead after an update for Jeff's anxious owners, Greg and Siobhan.
Come on, Jeff. I'll let you know how he's been overnight and I'll give you another ring later on tonight, probably about 9 o'clock-ish, something like that.
I'll be going back to educate my children.
Aye. Very much so. Very much so. Right, thanks a lot, guys. No bother. We'll speak to you soon. Cheers, guys. Bye. Bye. Come on, Jeff. Come on. I'll take him through to bed. We'll get him set up on his fluids. We'll give him a bowl of food with the charcoal in. If he'll eat and we can get the charcoal into him, that's great. The charcoal we're going to give him is hopefully going to bind some of those toxins in. The challenge is just getting it into him. Come on, Chief. Now then, what do you think to that? Come on, come on. You eat strawberries, please eat this meat charcoal-y feast. Ah, he's not going to have any of this meaty goodness. Might just have to reel Dr. Swinge in him, but... Yum, yum, yum. Relax, relax, relax. Scratches of the ears. Oh, it tastes like crap, doesn't it, I bet?
Some dogs love it.
Do they?
Yeah.
Well, they eat poo, so yeah. To be fair, a bit of...
We'll eat the lot.
Really?
Come on.
If only.
You've been a difficult patient today.
Come on.
That's it. Good boy.
That's it. Oh, well done, Tracy. We've given him some charcoal to soak up any toxins that are remaining. We've started him on his fluids and we've started him on some glucose to get into his body slowly, preventing that massive crash. So these next few hours are crucial. I'm going to stay in the next couple of hours, make sure everything's in place, and then we're going to monitor his bloods and sugars overnight, and we're going to check on him in the morning and see what's going on.
When it comes to problematic dogs and sweets, one of Julian's favourite former clients has seen it all before.
So I've come to see my old friend, Betty Taylor. I used to look after her dogs some years ago, and I come and see her from time to time just to keep in touch and say hello. She's a good mate. And I brought Emmy. Betty likes it when Emmy comes to visit. So I've seen Betty many times over the years. She had a couple of dogs. Billy was a real favourite of mine, and Betty was really besotted with Billy. Full of character, full of fun. They always brought a smile to everybody's face when he came into the practice.
But Billy had issues.
His bottom's dreadful. Poo, 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 poo. A lot of poo. Can you smell him?
That's pretty grim, isn't it, under there?
Really? Just stuck on him.
Oh, you can have him.
One of the most comical occasions when Betty came to see me at the practice, Billy had a very nasty, or we thought it was initially, a very nasty lump.
It's rock hard, isn't it? It's like a pebble.
Betty was very worried it was hard and firm and had appeared almost overnight.
Oh, poor Billy.
It turned out to be nothing more sinister than a jelly baby, I think it was, that had stuck onto the hair.
I think it's a jelly baby, Mrs. Taylor.
Billy with a jelly baby.
I'd have felt a complete idiot if we anaesthetised him only to surgically remove a sweet. For Billy, honestly. You're full of surprises, aren't you? Hello, Betty. You all right?
What's all this carry-on?
Well, I know you've had a very special birthday recently.
Don't talk about it.
And I brought you a birthday present to bring back some, hopefully, some happy memories. And I brought Emmy to say hello.
How old is she?
She's about 8, I think, now.
She's on one of your books.
She is, yeah, she's on a lot of them, yeah.
How old are the boys?
Jack's 18, and he's going to university soon.
Is it?
And, yeah, Archie's 15.
Are you
baby? Emmy wants to have a look. Em, look what's in this wrapping paper. So open your parcel, let's see if you can recognise who it is.
Ooh, I will do.
Emmy thinks it's food.
No, you are lovely, aren't you?
It's Billy. And he was a happy dog, but he always seemed to have this frown on his face.
Well, he has, hasn't he?
Do you remember that time when you came in and you were very worried? We were both worried. He'd got a lump and we thought it was a tumour, and then I started feeling it and it was all sticky. But things were always sticking to Billy. Do you remember sometimes the poo would stick to his bottom as well?
Bulky thing.
It was. But he was a nice little dog, wasn't he? It's a nice picture. It's not
what
got him.
It is beautiful. I don't know what he's got on.
I think that's the back of the chair, isn't it? I think he used to sit on the back of the chair, and when people came to the door or dogs walked past, he'd bark like mad.
Oh, it's absolutely beautiful.
So it was really lovely to see Betty again. She's always on good form. She's always really funny. But you're looking well, and you're full of fun as ever. You always put a smile on people's face, and hopefully this little picture of Billy will put a smile on your face as well. She loved to see Emmy, and it's really nice just to catch up with an old friend and put a smile on her face. Have a good evening and good afternoon, and see you again.
I'll go to sleep again.
Cheerio.
Bye.
Nice to see you again.
Bye.
Near Kirby Moorside, Peter's popped over to see Gertrude the goat after trimming her painful feet.
Gertie was suffering from laminitis, and as a consequence, her feet were a little distorted. It's not easy to control. Worst case scenario with Gertrude is that she's got worse, despite us trying to get her feet back to a more normal shape. So I was just interested to see how she was getting on. Morning, Kirsty.
Hello.
How are you?
Yeah, good, thank you. Do you want to come and have a look?
Gertie.
We'll see if we can get her over.
I think she's recognised me this morning. She certainly doesn't want to come anywhere near the chap that'll give her quite a significant pedicure.
Gertrude. Here we go, Gertrude. Here we go, Gertrude. Good girl.
She's keeping a distance from me. Animals aren't daft. Only she's moving quite nicely. Very nicely.
She's moving around a lot easier than she was.
Good.
So she's improved greatly.
And spending less time on her knees?
No time on her knees, really.
Oh,
and she was resting on the barrel over there, and she's not doing that anymore.
And the other thing, that she's standing there, she's got her front feet pulled under her. Yeah. There's a tendency with laminitis to have them out in front to take more weight on her heel. So as she's standing there, she's telling me that her feet are feeling quite good.
Yeah.
And she looks happy.
Yeah, she does. She's a lot perkier than she was previously.
Excellent. It's plainly obvious that Gertrude is feeling a lot better. I can tell that from the way she's standing and particularly the way she's hurtling around the field. And you don't do that if your feet are hurting. So she's feeling full of herself and I'm really pleased to see it.
In Huddersfield, after not getting much sleep, Matt's checking on Jeff.
All right, morning, Jeff. Let's see how you're getting on.
The bulldog who poisoned himself by eating chewing gum.
I was here until midnight last night, getting him sorted with all his treatment and his supportive therapy. And overnight, his blood sugars did start to drop. Hey. He has ingested a chunk of those toxins there, so the next 12 hours we're going to keep an eye on those blood sugars because this toxin has a delayed onset of activity with the liver and it can cause a lot of damage. Good lad, in you go, that's it. We've moved into a bigger suite where he can roam about a little bit more and he has been eating as well, so that'll certainly help him out. All right, see you soon, Chief. Positive so far, but definitely not out of the woods.
Jean and Steve Green treat their animals as part of the family.
Hello, you lot.
And their calves have always been at the heart of their farming life. So when a calf becomes sick, there's no time to waste.
We bought two new calves on Wednesday.
And one's a bit poorly.
And they're called Bubble and Squeak.
He's a bit off colour.
He's got what we call the trots.
So this morning, Peter's had a very early telephone call.
If diarrhoea isn't caught fairly early in young calves, it can be a bit of a problem. Right. Mrs. Green doesn't hang about too long if she's concerned. She's straight on the blower. I thought you'd be in here.
Yeah.
Hello, you little rogue, how are you?
Little rogue? Who are you calling a little rogue?
You?
Have you had your hair cut?
Yeah.
Well, you look very smart. And you've got a couple of new inmates, I understand.
Yes, I've got Bubble and Squeak.
And I think one of them's got a touch of diarrhoea. Ah, well, there's the evidence. That's pretty watery diarrhoea. Bubble and Squeak haven't been on the farm very long, and, you know, when they come onto a new farm, just the transport here can be quite stressful, and it may be that triggered the diarrhoea off. And it can soon develop into something more sinister and more nasty, and, yes, it's not nice, is it? At this age, calves can soon dehydrate, and it can soon be a major problem.
Still to come.
We were upset, weren't we?
It was a sleepless night.
Plenty to chew on for Jeff, the bulldog's owners.
What will we never, ever have in the sweet cupboard
chewing
again?
Gum.
Chewing gum.
Boy.
And is there hope for the young llama with a broken jaw?
Good boy, I said, not bad boy.
It seems Rowan's not keen to find out.
That's not what I was hoping for.
Peter's at Jean and Steve's farm.
Keep coming.
And with Bubble out of the way...
You're like the Pied Piper, Steve, leading him out there.
He needs to examine Squeak, who has a spot of tummy trouble.
It's pasty stuff, that, Jean, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
It looks as if somebody just sprayed it up the wall, doesn't it? Come on, you. I'm just looking at his eyes there to see if they're starting to sink at all, because that's a sign of dehydration. That's quite good. So this fellow isn't dehydrated yet, and that's purely because they've rung early, and that makes a big difference. Right, I'm just going to just check the temperature now. There's a lot of diarrhea around this tail, isn't there?
Can I just borrow this?
You can.
I just want to
Now, temperature is just a little bit low, and you often get that with diarrhoea.
Excuse me, sir. Got your wing nuts?
I'm very pleased Mrs. Green took over examination of Mr. Green and that his heart is beating well.
Can you hear?
It's when you can't hear it, Steve, that you start to worry. Mrs. Green, I think, is going to be Thirsk's new cardiologist, so all's well in the world.
We are men.
What we need is some electrolyte solution.
Yeah.
So I'm going to leave you some for the next feed. I'm just going to give one shot of long-acting antibiotic, and this will just help him to stop the E. coli's rearing up, and then hopefully within 24 hours we'll be back to normal. If you feel a prick, Mrs. Green, just don't be too worried.
Go!
Lovely. Next feed, just one of these mixed together.
Yeah.
And then tonight...
Next feed, you'll give him that with a tad of bitty milk.
You know better than I do, don't you?
I know what you're doing.
I must admit, it is nice to see calves. And I like to see them thriving. We've got to eat early.
That, is it easy peasy, lemon squeezy?
Something like that. That's easy for you to say.
Yeah.
I'm very pleased with the outcome there. Squeak should be absolutely fine now and fit and raring to go. So, in those famous words, hunky dory, Jack and Ori.
You've done a good job, Peter. That was a good job.
Well, we know our best between us, don't we? Have you much on today?
Well, I should be cutting grass, but I've lost the lawnmower.
Where you've got your grass to cut, you don't think it'd be a good idea to have half a dozen sheep in? You've never had sheep, have you, really?
No.
When did you move here?
1944.
So sheep would be a new venture, wouldn't it?
Hardly.
And you can't teach an old dog new tricks, can you?
No.
It's been 2 months since Bulldog Jeff poisoned himself by eating chewing gum and was rushed to the Huddersfield Hospital.
Okay, right. I'll be back soon.
By Greg and Siobhan.
All right, darling, I'm so there. Good lad.
The team did everything they could to save Jeff's life with some intensive treatment.
Relax, relax, relax.
Good boy.
See you soon, Chief.
And thankfully, Jeff has made a full recovery. And is eating sensibly.
Jack, come on, then.
My biscuit.
Where's your dinner?
Yeah, when he came back from the vets, we were upset, weren't we?
It was a sleepless night.
I think we were just quite shocked at how serious it could have been. And certainly an eye-opener. Speaking to people after it had happened, it was surprising how many people weren't aware of how toxic xylitol is.
When he came home, he went up in the back bedroom and that's where he stayed. He didn't really talk to anybody,
did he? For the rest of the night.
But then they gave him some food. Girls gave him some cuddles. It was back to his normal self.
Yeah.
Where's your ball?
He's hiding it.
No, got no chance.
What? What you got?
He had to go back to the vets every day.
Like,
to have a blood test.
To have his blood test, see what his blood count was.
The kids had a massive lecture about massive not lecture. Leaving stuff around.
Jeffrey, Jeffrey!
So this is where, what, Brooke?
A sweets go.
What will we never, ever have in the sweet cupboard again? Chewing gum. It is banned for life.
Still as hungry as an horse. Can't slow him down one bit.
Yeah, he would literally eat anything. So, yeah, we're just going to have to be very careful in the future.
Yeah.
Good boy, good boy.
He's like a hairy son and a hairy brother, isn't he? We love him to bits.
Yeah, he's doing absolutely great since it's not affected him in the slightest. We're just so glad he was OK.
Give him a kiss.
On a wild and windy afternoon in the Dales, Julian's hoping there'll be a brighter forecast for one of Suzanne Benson's youngsters.
I've come back to Nidderdale to see a little llama that I operated on a couple of months ago now. Rowan had a nasty fracture to the jaw, was really quite bad in a lot of pain. And I managed to fix it by putting some wire in the jaw to bring the fracture edges together.
Rowan was eating little bits of pellets to start with and little bits of hard feed here and there. He tried a bit of hay, kept spitting it out. So it's a vital process that needs to happen with a llama to be able to chew that fibre again and get the digestive process going. I'm hoping today Julian will be able to remove the braces easily and that he finds his jaw has actually fixed and it's solid. Worst case scenario is it hasn't fixed or there's another problem with it, but I'm really hoping that's not the case.
Hello.
Hiya, Julian.
Hello, Rowan.
Hey.
How's it been?
The first few days were quite stressful.
Is it firm?
It seems to be, although he's not letting us do a lot of handling of the old mouth.
Ideally, I'll try and take the wire out. I think the first step is we'll give him some sedative so he goes calm and relaxed. Yeah. Right then, Rowan, keep your legs down.
Good boy, good boy, good boy.
If you do it on the far side, and if he does kick you up, that bunch rather than me.
Good boy.
Do you think he'll let us look now?
You can try.
You can try and hold
to you. Can try.
Boy.
Rose.
Look, good boy, I said, not bad boy.
Oh, Rose. Dear me. Rose.
That's not what I was hoping for.
I think Rowan remembers you. Hey, Rowan.
She's dancing.
Good boy, good boy, good boy.
Shh. Rose, it's okay.
Good boy. I think that's
right. Do you think he'll calm down at all? You can see the wire. Look, there it is. Now it's still. We've got a chance. If I go to the top of your gobble.
I can't see, so please up top and go.
Tell me if it hurts. Oh, that was Jordan, didn't it?
That was easy enough. All that drama, Rowan, you see. You needn't have a drama.
Complete. Came out easily and it went in. Good, right. Shall we let him go and see whether he wants to go and nibble on some grass?
He'll
probably.
You'll probably go down
soon.
Now. You're free.
Go on, Rowan.
This is letting me get away from that vet. Relieved. In one word, really. I was just a bit hesitant we wouldn't be able to do it at all with the way Rowan was having a drama, but that's llamas for you. Once they realise you're trying to help, they become submissive and let you get on with it. Really pleased it's all worked out well, and it saved his life, to be honest, because otherwise, if he hadn't healed and he wouldn't have wanted to eat, he wouldn't be able to chew the cud. So it's just an amazing job.
And the Yorkshire Vets back next week at 8. Their mates at Cannon Hall are back tomorrow night. This week on the farm, Jules and Helen look at how farming is tackling climate change, new at 8. And elsewhere on the Dales, the Owens are back, juggling work on a bitterly cold farm with the kids homeschooling the new series of Our Yorkshire Farm, starting in just a moment.